Our next debater is, I am not wrong, is Judge Luke Lavrish. May I ask you to begin?
Thank you. Thank you very much, Madam Chair. What I like to do is to illustrate the added value of the Global Pact for the Environment for a national judge. And that's starting from a case of my own court, that is the Belgian Constitutional Court. And before presenting the case, I should say that our Constitutional Court is very open to international and European law by including international and European law provisions in our review of constitutionality of acts of the federal and regional parliaments. However, this has its limits. Although in our court, it's not necessary that international law provisions have so-called direct effect for being relied upon before our court in conjunction with constitutional provision, the court is not willing to go as far as to include soft law provisions or international policy declarations in its review. So, for example, the Stockholm or Rio declarations do not qualify to be taken into consideration in the court's review. The case I like to mention is a judgment of 27th of January 2016. It's called Galland and Inter Environnement Bruxelles. In 2007, in the Brussels capital region where we are now, based on the precautionary principle, very strict standards on radiation from mobile phone antennas has been introduced. And those standards were believed to be 200 times stricter than the values recommended by the International Commission on Non-Ionizing Radiation Protection. Standards also laid down in a recommendation of the European Community of that time from 1999. In 2014, the regional legislator believed that those standards were too strict, being an obstacle for the introduction of 4G communication, leading to a multiplication of such antennas in the Brussels region to have sufficient cover, and not necessary from an environmental and public health standpoint on the basis of the most recent scientific insights. The Parliament of the Brussels region had held hearings with various experts before lowering down the standards in the Act that was challenged before the court. But however, the new standards were still 50 times stricter than the values mentioned in the recommendation, the European Union recommendation and the recommendation of the International Commission. And that's a Belgian phenomenon, stricter than in the two other regions of Belgium, because this is a regional matter. Nevertheless, the Act was challenged for violation of the right to the protection of a healthy environment that we have in our Constitution, in conjunction with the precautionary principle. Problem for us, we do not have the precautionary principle as such in our Constitution. There is no international or European legally binding act stating that the precautionary principle should be applied on radiation of mobile phone antennas. In the Brussels regional law, the principle was only mentioned in water law, but not in mobile phone radiation law, so to speak. And there are no internationally or European binding standards for the maximum allowed radiation neither. So the question for the court was, is the precautionary principle applicable? And if so, how should we interpret this precautionary principle? Because many different understandings can be found in literature, from soft to hard, from a more enabling principle to a binding rule. With the Global Environmental Pact, that gap would have been filled. In Article 6 of the Pact, containing the principle, The principle is of a general nature, encompassing the matter at hand, and is giving some clear indications of how to understand that principle. In our judgment of 2016, the court turned itself at the end, via the recommendation of the European Commission, to Article 190 of the Treaty on the Function of the European Union, and further on to the jurisprudence of the Court of Justice of the European Union to interpret the principle, and the court followed the understanding of the precautionary principle by the Court of Justice of the European Union. But this was, let's say, whole reasoning to come to that. When the pact should have been enforced and ratified by Belgium, the exercise would have been easier. And as has been acknowledged by the Secretary General of the United Nations in its CAPS report of November 2018, there are many gaps in international environmental law, with many environmental issues that are out of scope of sectoral legislation. And although we have an impressive set of European Union environmental legislation, not every issue of importance has been regulated or is only regulated by way of minimum harmonization by the European Union lawmaker. So I think the Global Pact would be very helpful for national judges reviewing national laws, regulations and administrative acts, as it contains principles that have not been recognized yet in horizontal, international or binding European Union legal instruments. I refer, for example, to Article 2 on the duty to take care of the environment, to the principle of intergenerational equity, Article 4, the provision on environmental damages, Article 7, the principle on the role of non-state actors and subnational entities, Article 15, on resilience, Article 16, and on non-regression, Article 17. Other principles are very well covered in Europe, I think, to the ARUS procedural rights, but that's not the case in all regions of the world, of course. So the advantage, I think, of a comprehensive and concise pact is that it can be an entrance portal for national judges to international environmental law before turning, if applicable, to specific multilateral environmental agreements that might be applicable from time to time, depending on the case, but are not always easy to find and to understand by national judges. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge Lauritsen, for this inspiring intervention, giving us the examples of how pacts may help judiciary. By giving the legal instruments, and I should say that I will remember for a long time in front of me your expression. Mm-hmm. Pact may be an entrance portal for national judges to international environmental law. I wish judges in my country are listening to what you were saying.
Okay.
Thank you very much.